Hi, I'm Julio Barros, and this is my Intro to iOS Development video course. I'd like to thank you for taking the time and letting me introduce you to iOS development. I'm sure you'll find it interesting, challenging, and rewarding. If you have any questions or have any comments, please do not hesitate to contact me. I've been a developer for many years and had been programming in C, C++, and Java when I first saw the iPhone SDK. It was then that I got really excited because I saw the phone as a small, programmable computer that fits in your pocket that happened to make phone calls. Now with the iPad, I'm even more excited to be involved with this style of computing and programming. There were smartphones and downloadable apps before the iPhone, but iPhone was really the first device to perfect the combination of gorgeous hardware, amazingly capable and programmable software, and an easy-to-use app store for mass distribution. It's been a few years, and we've seen several versions of the phone and iPad, but we're still at the beginning of this, and there are plenty of opportunities to take this where you want to go. Though I mostly do native development, and this is a native application development class, let me point out to you that these devices have very capable web browsers that can be used for browsing regular traditional websites. It's also possible to create mobile websites that are specifically formatted for mobile devices. And you can, of course, create native applications for the ultimate user experience. You can also create native apps that use embedded web technology for much of their functionality. With that in mind, native applications can be complicated and take significant time and resources to develop. Only you can make the decision about when a web app is perfectly adequate and when a first-class native app is required. If you decide to prototype with HTML and CSS or create a mobile web app or hybrid app, there are a few toolkits that you should check out. Now, this course is a hands-on native iOS development course using Objective-C and Xcode from Apple. We'll be working with iPhone projects in this class, but everything you learn will be applicable to iPad applications. The programming is the same, but one thing to keep in mind is that design matters. You can't just blow up an iPhone app and have a great user experience on the iPad. You'll see that you need to think about it and restructure parts of the app to work well on the larger screen. For example, take a look at the Mail app on the iPhone. And now on the iPad. They were both created with Objective-C and Xcode, but their structure is very different. Other apps like WeatherBug are a little cramped and busy on the phone, but really shine on the iPad. Many apps are like this. And many other apps wouldn't make sense on the phone, but work really well on iPad. Either way, though, it's critical that you think carefully about what you are building, why you are building it, and how it should work before you go too far with a design that is not going to work for you. I'm a big proponent of prototyping and experimenting, but some people find it difficult to start over to correct issues once they've invested effort. You'll need to find that right balance for yourself. To get started, you'll need an Intel-based Mac. Anyone will do, and you probably already have one if you've gotten this far. You'll need to learn Objective-C, which entails getting used to long method names and square brackets. Objective-C really isn't that tough, though, and we'll get more into it later, and there are lots of great resources. You'll need to get familiar with some important frameworks and learn to find your way around the vast number of other frameworks. One of the awesome things about iOS is that it's built on top of Mac OS X and Next Step, and they've been around for many, many years, which means they are very robust and mature. But one of the things that can be overwhelming to new programmers is figuring out where everything is. You'll need to become familiar with Xcode. Xcode is an integrated development environment with an editor, interface builder, and debugger, and it also manages the process of building and packaging your application. And you'll want to register as a developer to get the SDK with Xcode. Apple also has lots of great documentation in the Developer Center. Currently, there's a free account, but if you want to submit apps to the App Store or even install one on your own device, you'll need to get a paid account, which is currently $99 a year. There are a lot of great resources in the Apple Developer Center, and if you'd like to get other points of view, there are now many excellent books available. So let's get started. Visit estring.com for more training and iOS development information.